Every medication that is ordered for you in a hospital, a pharmacist is involved in that, whether it is verifying the order, admixing the medication if it's an IV, and making sure it's compounded sterilely so that we keep you safe, and also getting those medications safely to your bedside, and that we are sure that none of those medications are interacting with each other or adversely affecting maybe the reason why you're there. We're not able to keep every single medication in the hospital from a cost standpoint, and so pharmacists play a vital role in ensuring that we have the medications that our patients are going to benefit from the most in the hospital when they need it. Hospital pharmacists can work in a variety of different ways on an interprofessional team. I would say the traditional way is pharmacists would be with the physician or the provider who is kind of in charge of that patient. It's their patient for the day. We work with occupational therapists, physical therapists, respiratory therapists. Really anyone that you would interact with in the hospital can be a part of the interprofessional team, depending on what those patients' needs are. We have a second year experience, an introductory pharmacy practice experience, where students will spend 2 weeks in the summer inside a hospital and seeing how a hospital pharmacy works. What does a hospital pharmacist do? How do you get medications from the pharmacy to the patient? And how do patients move through the hospital? And that's a really important experience to understand the logistics.
Gatton really focuses on providing education to patients. We have a lot of things called OSCEs that we do, where we actually interview, we call them SPs, that kind of give us real life interactions to what it might be like out on the outside. So we practice that, we practice counseling. We have actually an OSCE station where we do just like a variety of things like blood pressure checks. So we practice those skills. We've pricked our own fingers. I took a diabetes elective where I actually got to wear a continuous glucose monitor, so I got to see how it felt for people with diabetes to wear one of those.
We had a patient who had been admitted to our service several times over the course of a couple of months, and she was always coming to the hospital with a really high blood pressure to the point that she was having really bad headaches and she was having a hard time breathing. And so the question was always, well, she's on all these medications, why is her blood pressure so high? She had changed pharmacies and the new pharmacy didn't have her insurance information and she didn't know how to get that to them and she couldn't afford her medication. We called her old pharmacy and we, you know, got her insurance information. We called her new pharmacy and ensured that her co-pays were going to be something that she could afford on her fixed income. And I've never seen that patient again. You would think that in the hospital, it's always this glamorous life-saving story, but a lot of times it's just the simple things that make a big difference for patients. And she has always stuck with me that, you know, in that moment when you're like, what can I do for this patient? Sometimes it's really just the simplest thing.